back.
First things first, if you've seen my other videos, you noticed I'm blonde now. If you don't like it, that's okay. A couple people didn't, but tell you what, it grows on you. It is a little past midnight. I'm on staff duty in the Army. You know how it is. Luckily, my jurisdiction is this gym. I'm in here for 24 hours, so I figured might as well make a comeback YouTube video. So to kick it off, we're gonna start with the warm up. That's right, don't forget to warm up. It's really important, especially if you're getting older, like me. It doesn't have to be anything crazy. Stretch out the joints, get a little bit of blood flow going. Take care of your body, and it'll take care of you. And the lighting in this gym is actually really sick. I hope it translates on camera, but working out in here, definitely a vibe. So, a typical breakdown of my full body split. I like to start off with back, then chest, then biceps, triceps, shoulders, and finish off with legs. I found that's what works best for me, and I get the most out of my workouts if I go in that order. Rep range will vary depending on the exercise and the body part. Anywhere from 8 to 15 reps is usually where I stay around. It's been working for me to both get my strength back as well as build muscle at the same time. So enough talking for now, let's do it! Very well. Now that our backs are nice and tight like a tiger, ready to move on to chest. Chest is my weakest body part. It's hardest for me to grow. So I'm sticking to a lot of incline, and I'll be doing incline dumbbells. Relatively heavy. Call it 8 to 10 rep range. So hundreds are the heaviest dumbbells I have here. So that was my limit. That was 3 sets. Feeling pretty pumped up now. Time to move on to arms. By the way, I said I was in the Army. I'm in Hawaii. So if you're also stationed in Schofield, maybe you've recognized my car. Like a cruise ship. Ooh. Is that a boat? Guru from the sea, now you gotta get your own fruit, bitch. Or if you just live in Hawaii. But if you see it around, feel free to say what's up. Oh, and check it out. I upgraded my equipment. Check out this nifty little thing. Boop. Official. Got a legit little Sony camera I also use for photography. Got my little microphone. Did you hear that? No major secret. Just gotta do it. Good contraction. Relatively high repetitions. How weird is it when you're on one of these shared cable machines and you look across because there's another machine right there and you got this guy just locked in. Oh, you see that? See that? Shit. Tricep action? Your boy's sturdy. I like a lot of volume with these. I go about 15 rep range. If you want to make it extra spicy, you can do the 2 second hold, quick 2 second holds, slow up, and so on. 3 sets, that about covers tricep. Now we move on to shoulders. Arguably one of the most important body parts that really makes a physique. Don't believe me? Ask a girl. You want those rounded off shoulders, really, you know, make that taper of the body. And you can't go wrong with lateral raises. You can never do too many lateral raises. That heavy overhead press, volume for lateral raises, key to success for shoulders. Circle got small, money got long. Continue the marathon, none of the nip gone. Circle got small, money got long.
Continue the marathon, now that nip gone. Cultivating. Help cultivating wealth.
So shoulders is done. Now would be the time that I would do legs. And no, I'm not trying to weasel my way out of doing legs. But last week at work, doing a Breachers Academy, and I banged up my knee pretty good. So I have to, unfortunately, not do anything with my lower body right now and just let it heal up. There's a difference between pain and injury. And if you try to push through an injury, you're only gonna make it worse and you're gonna be out even longer. But I really do enjoy actually doing legs, so. But yeah, in conclusion, the last couple months I've been doing this full body split and it's really been working for me. It's not too mundane and boring like I found a bro split to be. I didn't wanna just go and do chest for an hour or back, even though I love back. But I didn't wanna just do one body part. And that way I can lightly touch everything every day and feel refreshed, ready to go, and excited about hitting everything every time I go into the gym to train and I get the most out of it. Also, when my knee wasn't injured, I was doing a zone 2 cardio so I'd be mostly running for anywhere from 3 to 5, maybe 6 miles in the mornings. Nice, easy pace, nothing crazy. Manageable that I could do most days in the week. Then after work in the afternoons or evenings, that's when I would do my gym session and doing the full body split. I'd be in and out of the gym in an hour. Most days I would also do core and or another form of cardio, which would be just probably walking on the treadmill for 20 minutes at a 140 heart rate. And that would be my fat burning cardio. And the morning runs would be my aerobic fitness. If you fancy yourself a hybrid athlete of some sort, then I would definitely give this a try. And let me know what you think. But thank you so much for tuning in. It really means a lot. I'll be more consistent with these vlog, gym videos, whatever people are watching and clicking on. That's the more stuff I'll be doing, but I wanna be doing more vlogs as well. Yeah, tune in for the next one. Subscribe if you haven't already. I appreciate it. Be easy.